Hello and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Brian Jinks, and today I'm going to be talking about Raindrop.io, a critical component in my workflow for personal knowledge management and using Obsidian. There's a lot of applications and services that provide the same functionality as Raindrop.io. Some people use Notion as a collection point of like things to read and process. I've used Pocket before. MyMind was something that I've seen come up. But I've settled for Raindrop.io for a couple particular reasons. So, what is Raindrop.io and how can you use it? So at first, the interface of Raindrop.io, it's pretty simple. You got all of your folders on the left called collections, and this is as simple as it gets. It's a collection point. So why might you use something like this versus something like MyMind? This has been something that's been on my radar for a little while, and it has its pros, it has its cons. But why would you use this over MyMind or another service? I've tried Pocket and I've tried several other collection point type applications where I just want to send all the stuff that I want to review and process in my Zettelkasten workflow within Obsidian. And this has been the thing that's just been easiest for me. It's easy, it gets out of the way, doesn't cost me anything. There are paid options and services, but I, with my workflow, do not need them. And I get by just fine on the free model, and I enjoy it. It gets out of my way, and it lets me get my work done and save the things that I want to look at later. The one major difference between Raindrop.io and MyMind that's really popped out to me, two main things, well, three. MyMind is already going to be paid right off the bat. You're going to have to pay for it, I believe. And it does do the AI auto-tagging your content, so it does all the tagging for you, which for some is a plus if you're saving a lot of stuff. It makes it easier to find it. And then there's no structure. Raindrop.io, you have collections and folders and whatnot. MyMind, it's just a pool, a top-level pool, just like a lot of the new personal knowledge management type applications nowadays, Rome Research, Obsidian, all these things that operate at a top level. It's like that, but it auto-assigns your tags for you, lets you add some of your own. It's a really interesting application. It was on my radar ever since I saw this video by Shu Omi, and it was a really interesting, you know, application. I wanted to try it out, I wanted to test it out, and I think I gave it a little bit of a try. It was all right. I would use it, but I didn't really want to pay for it. And for at least what I was doing with my workflow, I wanted basically a linear pipeline. So Raindrop.io, it just serves a better purpose for me. It actually checks the boxes for what I wanted to do. So it's never a case of this is better than this. It's more of this is better for me than that. So that is why I'm actually using Raindrop.io. But as for how to use it, that's what we're gonna get into next. So as for the types of content you can put into Raindrop, one thing I know that doesn't work well is Reddit. Because I did have an RSS feed for Reddit, for the subreddits that I like to follow up here, and it won't open the posts at all in Raindrop. So really what I'm reduced to is I actually have the RSS feeds in my RSS feed reader, and I just look at the Reddit there, and if there's a post I like and want to save and review later and actually take notes from it, then I'll actually push it into my inbox in Raindrop. Other than that, I think it handles everything else pretty well. Websites, tweets, YouTube. You can put research papers, articles, blog posts, all kinds of different things. Basically a URL and you're good. And I basically just clip everything. There's a browser clipper here and you can also add things manually, or there is also a phone clipper and an app that you can use. So there's a lot of ways of making this your central hub as like an inbox and cataloging your collection of items and things that you want to read and process. Raindrop is free, but the paid services, you know, maybe one day I might actually spring for this, but some of the paid services that you could get are like suggested tags, kind of like how MyMind was, you know, marketing themselves, nested collections, basically a nested hierarchy of your folder structure, finding duplicates, broken links, full text search of your articles or whatever, and keeping a permanent library, so basically like the internet archive, but of your saved items. You know, if you're really, really wanting to hold on to everything with like an iron fist, the paid option might be an avenue for you. But To be honest, everything that I get out of this, it's fine. Because one, I save the links in my Obsidian articles and notes anyways, so like I have the links. And really what I'm using this for is the inbox for what I'm going to process into ideas and notes in Obsidian. So the end goal is not to have all this stuff collected and searchable. The end goal is to have my distilled information and ideas into Obsidian, which I have under like version control and cloud storage anyways. So for my purposes, a single level folder structure and a inbox and it unpaid features, like this is fine for what I use it for. But you might want a more robust option. It's not that expensive. $3 a month, I think it said. That's not that bad. But in any case, I'm not sponsored, by the way. I just really like the service. So like I said, the nesting of the folders is a paid feature. You know, it's kind of a weird paid feature. But in any case, one thing I really do like is that the icons for folders are on point. Like, okay, we're visual creatures. The aesthetics are cool, but the icons for these folders are awesome. Like, you can have all different kinds of emojis and icons from all different kinds of sets and options for things that you search for. Like, I wanted a Medium icon for this folder for where I hold Medium articles. And look at how many different things pop up that you have, like, options for. So, I mean, that's just, like, a small benefit. Something that I thought was pretty interesting. So with that nested folder structure stuff, like it doesn't matter for me simply because my entire process is top level. I have my central inbox, and then once I process things and want to keep them, I file them in their folders based on like what the item is. Beyond that, it doesn't matter to me. So this whole top level thing, totally fine. Another cool feature I like about this is that it will actually let you read things within Raindrop. Especially like articles or websites, posts. I think there's like some tweets I have in here somewhere. Somewhere I got some tweets in here. There we go. So like if I want to look at a tweet, I can actually see it in here. No, okay, so I can't watch this one. This is the same thing as Reddit. Like this will actually not open, but oh, wait, there it goes. Never mind, there we go. So in this case, I can actually see like tweets in here. I can read articles in here, so theatlantic.com, and you know it'll open up the web page, or I can just say article, and this is kind of like if I was reading in Pocket. But one thing I really like about this previewer is that if you don't have a paid subscription to Medium, you can read your articles on Medium in here without having to pay anything. Now there was a hack for this where if you DM'd a Medium article to somebody, they could read it. So if you just DM'd yourself on Twitter a Medium article link, you wouldn't have to pay, but I think they fixed that one. But in this case, you know, here I am putting it out there, but you can actually read Medium on here for free. So that's pretty cool. And so we can actually tag items in here, but I'm just gonna go over my entire workflow. That way you can see how I'm actually using tags and why I use them in the way that I do. So if I find an article I like, so if I go to medium.com and I find an article that I really want to save, I can easily just go to that article and send it to Raindrop. So let's see, 10 time saving R hacks. Yeah, that sounds like something I'd look at. So now what do I do? Well, I'm in the browser. Cool. So I can't even read this right now because I don't pay. I just write. So I want to save this. I have a little Raindrop Chrome extension right here, raindrop.io, send it to there. And with one click, all I need to do is click that. It's added to my inbox or the last folder. Sometimes it's set to unsorted. I just put it to my inbox. I don't have to add any tags. I could just do that and I'm done. Cool. But I do add one tag. I have two main tags that I use, and that is 0 and 1. 0 and 1. Why those, you might ask? I don't add a lot of tags prolifically unless I actually care about what I'm looking at. So in this case, what I'm doing is I'm saving something to be read later. It's in my inbox. I don't know if I like it or not. I've just saved it for later. What I do is I use 0 and 1 basically to indicate the status of whether it's been read by me or not. So if I have read the item, it's a 1. And then I just know I can easily just take cursory notes or whatever, or I need to file it. But if it's a 0, then I have not read that item and I need to read it and process it. After I process an item, if I don't like it, I just delete it. If I like the item and I take notes and I found it useful and it actually merits having, you know, a post or a note in my Obsidian Zettelkasten, then it's really worth its place. So I actually change it to a red tag, which is a 1, and then I file it under the type of content it is. If it's an article, I might put, you know, either blog posts or website, whatever. And if it's a Medium article, I file it here. You can see where I might file stuff. I mean, it's pretty obviously laid out. So after I read it and I take notes and I like it, I will file it and add relevant search tags. So I have a blog post in here about like spaced repetition. And you know, I've read it, spaced repetition, active recall, memory, memorization, Anki, learning. These are the tags that I gave it. So now when I search for tags, this is actually findable by those tags. Now, I don't mind doing this manually because I'm not processing at a rate where having a paid service that does it for me really justifies its expense. So this is fine for me because I will process something in my inbox, add the notes, file it if I like it, and then add tags. So if I wanted to, it's searchable in here. But ultimately, I don't really care about having it searchable. It's nice, but you know, I'm not as much of a hoarder to make sure I have all my URLs are, you know, forever. It's really just about, can I keep this and the precipitates of it that I actually care about, which is the ideas in the notes. So for instance, I actually did take a note on the video from my mind that Shuomi put out. And you know, I got a link to it, I got the iframe embed, I got my notes, pros and cons, you know, and this worked. So if I actually had this in Raindrop, I would have filed this under, you know, YouTube, but I didn't, and I don't really care to put it there because I've already processed it and I'm done. Really, the ultimate goal is not hoarding everything. The ultimate goal is processing it and actually getting those precipitate ideas out and into Obsidian. So once it's done, I file it and I'm good. One thing I do have is an RSS feed reader. I'm a big fan of RSS. Now, I don't have the RSS feeds going to my inbox in Raindrop for one specific purpose. And this is like a critical thing when it comes to just sending yourself like a fire hose in the face of content, is that it's not about I can process this much and put it into Obsidian and my Zettelkasten. It's quality over quantity. So I use my RSS feeds in my RSS feed reader, which is really just, what is this called again? RSS reader. You know, it's free, I got it from the App Store, done. And I just put my RSS feeds in here. It's easy, it actually exports to an OPML file, so it is portable, it's not gonna like lock you in or anything. And I use this as the place where all of my RSS feeds are being sent to. If I like something here, I'll then open it up in the browser, clip it into Raindrop, and then read it later. Because currently I got so much stuff on my back burner to process, especially with research papers, I don't have time to just sit down and read all my RSS feeds right now, as you can tell by how many unread items I have. I use this as like the landing point of RSS, not my inbox. My inbox is stuff that I have personally handpicked and said, I want to read that later though. So that's what my inbox is for. My inbox is only for what I cherry pick. The RSS feed is just the fire hose. Like, shoot everything at me. I'll cherry pick what I want from it. And this is currently like the setup I have for trapping the content that I want to look at later in a place that is consolidated and in one place. And it's also really easy to use your phone to do this as well. If I'm actually reading on my phone, if you're mobile and out and about, but you want to save it for later, you can use Raindrop IO on your phone. And using Raindrop on your phone, super easy. I can go somewhere like say medium.com and find an article I want to read, and but I can't read it now, so I want to save it for later. I can share it, and there should be an app icon like for Raindrop, and if there isn't, you can click the triple dot ellipsis and find that app and add it to your list. But you share it to Raindrop, I'm going to send it to my inbox, and then it will put it in there, and then I can add my tags, which is really just the 0 to say that it's unread by me and I need to read it, and I'm done. And when I get home later, it'll be there in my inbox waiting for me. And that's all there is to it, to use it on your phone. So hopefully you find this interesting and you enjoy using this tool as well. If you do, let me know what you use it for. But this is probably one of the biggest collection points in my pipeline for my Zettelkasten. And I really enjoy the product, not sponsored, just like it a lot. And hopefully you found this interesting. So before I go, a quick shout out to the patrons who support the channel. Thank you, Devin, Klaus, Alberto, and Brandon. You guys are supporting the channel, and some of you have been around for a very long time, and I thank you for your support. So I will catch you all in the next one.